Applying theorems on triangle inequality. This is your math teacher, Sir Marvin Panagiton. These are the objectives. Let's define what is triangle inequality theorem. The sum of the lengths of any two sides of a triangle is greater than the length of the third side. Let us have an example. Segment AB plus segment AC is greater than segment BC. Segment AB plus segment BC is greater than segment AC. Segment AC plus segment BC is greater than segment AB. What did you notice? The sum of any two sides of a triangle is always greater than the remaining third side of the triangle. Examples. Can the side lengths of form a triangle? Explain. Note that the sum of the lengths of any two sides of a triangle must be greater than the length of the third side. Always remember na dapat po ang sum ng any two sides of a triangle must be greater than to the remaining third side of the triangle. So kung mayroon pong case na yung sum ng dalawang side, kagaya po nito, 5 plus 3, greater than po ba sa 9? No. Therefore, the measures cannot create a triangle. For letter B, the sum of any two sides, for example, 5 plus 3, is it greater than 8? No. So therefore, this three measure cannot create a triangle. For letter C, since any two sides or the sum of any two sides is always greater than the third side of a triangle, therefore, it can create a triangle. So it is yes. How to find the range of the third side of a triangle? The range of the possible measure for the third side of a triangle is greater than the difference of lengths of given two sides and less than the sum of the lengths of the given two sides. So these are the pattern used to find the range of the third side of a triangle. So, kung mapapansin nyo po, same lamang po yung symbol natin. Ito lamang po yun. On the left side is the difference of the measure of the two sides. Dito ilalagay sa left side yung sagot po kapag pinag-minus nyo po yung dalawang given measure. Sa kanan naman po, dito natin nilalagay yung sum or yung sagot kapag pinag-plus nyo po yung dalawang given measure. Let's have an example. Find the range of the third side of a triangle given the lengths of the two sides. First na gagawin po natin is ilalagay na po natin yung symbol in terms of x. On the left side of this illustration is you're going to subtract 8 minus 5. On the right side, you're going to add 8 plus 5. Then again, copy lang natin. Ito pong gitnang ito. Then, 8 minus 5 is 3. 8 plus 5 is 13. So, the possible measures, since x is greater than 3 and x is less than 13, the possible measures of the third side is from 4 to 12. or 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Letter B, 12,7. Again, you're going to put this pattern or symbol. On the left side, you're going to subtract 12 minus 7. On the right side, you're going to add 12 plus 7. Then, simplify. 12 minus 7 is 5. 12 plus 7 is 19. So, therefore, x is greater than 5 and x is less than 19. So, the possible measures of the third side is or are from 6 to 18 because x is greater than 5, so which is 6, and x is less than 19, which is 18. The exterior angle inequality theorem. The measure of the exterior angle of a triangle is equal to the sum of the measure of its two remote interior angles. So let us have this triangle. If you're going to extend one side of a triangle, it can create the what we call exterior angle. And the two angles which are not adjacent to the exterior angle is what we call remote interior angles. So always remember that an exterior angle is equal to the measure of one remote interior angle plus the measure of the other remote interior angle. So let us have an example number one. Find the value of x. So what do you call to this angle? This is the exterior angle. So how to find the exterior angle? Let us have a formula. The measure of the exterior angle is equal to the measure of one remote interior angle plus the measure of the other remote interior angle. Then by substitution, papalitan natin si exterior angle ng x, papalitan natin si remote interior angles ng 50 and 60 degrees. So, 50 degree plus 60 degrees. Then, we're going to simplify. X degree is equal to 110 degree. So, the value of x is 110. Example number 2. Find the value of x. Since the x is the measure of one of the remote interior angles, so, you were going to use the formula one remote interior angle plus the other remote interior angle is equal to the measure of the exterior angle. So, let's substitute the values of the three. So, the remote interior angle is 54 degrees plus the x degree is equal to 115 degrees. Take note of this. Pwede pong magkapalit po ang dalawang ito. Same lamang po ang patutunguhan ng sagot. Then after that, kailangan po using subtraction property of equality, kailangan po mawala po yung constant sa kaliwa. So what are we going to do? We subtract both sides of the equation by negative or minus 54. So, magma-minus po tayo ng 54 dito, magma-minus tayo dito ng 54. Then, x na lamang po yung matitira is equal to 61 degrees. So, the measure of this remote interior angle is 61 degrees. Example number 3. Find the value of x, measure of angle CAD, and the measure of angle C. So, what is the relationship of these given measures? So, the relationship of these given measures is that this is the exterior angle and it is equal to the sum of the two remote interior angles. So therefore, we're going to use the formula. The measure of the exterior angle is equal to the measure of one remote interior angle plus the measure of the other remote interior angle. Then, by substitution, papalitan lang natin si exterior angle ng 5x plus 7 is equal to, papalitan natin si remote interior angle. So, maalin po sa dalawa kahit magkabaliktad po silang dalawa. So, unahin natin si 20 degrees or 20 plus 5x plus 3x. Then, after that, tingnan po natin ang equation. Tingnan natin yung right side of the equation. Meron po bang term na may variable x or any variable? Yes, meron tayo. That is 3x. So, kailangan natin gumamit ng subtraction property of equality para po mawala po yung term na may variable dito sa kanan. So, anong gagawin natin? Minus 3x. Then, tingnan natin yung left side of the equation. May constant po ba tayong nakita? Yes, 7. So, therefore, kailangan natin tanggalin ang 7 dito sa left side of the equation using the subtraction property of equality. So, magma-7 tayo. Then, after that, we simplify. 5x minus 3x, that is 2x, is equal to 20 plus 5 is 25 minus 7, that is 18. So, kung mapapansin nyo po, 7 minus 7 is 0, so wala na po yan. Then, 3x minus 3x is 0, so wala na rin po yan. So, what property po ang susunod natin gagamitin para mawala po yung coefficient na 2? So, we're going to divide both sides by 2 using the division property of equality. Then, divide out natin si 2, so wala na. X na lamang po matitira is equal to 18 divided by 2 is 9. So, nakuha na po natin yung value ng x, which is 9. So, let's find the measure of angle CAD. So, ano po ba yung measure ng angle CAD? Angle CAD. So, that is 5x plus 7. Then, after that, by substitution, papalitan lang natin si x ng 9. 5 times 9 is 45 plus 7, that is 52 degrees. So, the measure of angle CAD is 52 degrees. Next, what is the measure of angle C? So, the measure of angle C is 5 plus 3x. Then, by substitution, papalitan lang natin si x ng 9. Then, simplify. 3 times 9, 27 plus 5, that is 32 degree. So therefore, the measure of angle C is 32 degrees. Let us solve the hinge theorem or the SAS triangle inequality theorem. If two sides of one triangle are congruent to the two sides of another triangle, and the included angle of the first is larger than the included angle of the second, then the third side of the first is longer than the third side of the second. Sa hinge theorem, dito po natin kino-compare po yung third side na sinasabi natin. So, let us have example number 1. Solve an inequality for possible values of x. So, kung mapapansin nyo, dito po sa illustration natin, meron tayong two congruent sides. So, segment AC is congruent to segment DF. Segment AB is congruent to segment DE. Now, tingnan natin po yung angle. Since angle A is greater than angle D, so pwede po nating sabihin na yung katapat na side ni angle A, ito yon, segment BC, is greater than or longer than segment EF. So, ilalagay natin, segment BC is greater than segment EF. Then, by substitution, papaltan lamang po natin si BC ng 3x plus 1. Is greater than, kopya. Papaltan natin si EF ng 2x plus 3. Then, tingnan po natin yung atin pong inequality. Yung right side, meron po ba kayo nakitang term na may variable? Yes. So, 2x. So, kailangan mawala. Ano ang gagawin natin? Apply subtraction property of equality. So, minus 2x. Magma-minus ka rin ng 2x sa kabila. May constant po ba sa kaliwa? Yes. Meron. So, 1. So, mag-minus 1. Minus 1. Then, simplify. 3x minus 2x. That is x. Ito po'y 0 na. Then, put is greater than. Then, 2x minus 2x is 0. 3 minus 1 is 2. Therefore, the possible values of x is greater than 2. So, ano yung mga possible values of x kung greater than 2? We have 3, 4, 5, up to positive infinity. So, walang kapatapusan po ito. Basta positive. Let us have example number 2. Compare by using the correct inequality symbol, then solve the possible values of x. So, what is the correct inequality symbol? So, we have the given included angle, 36 degree and 32 degree. So, which is the larger angle? Is it 36 or 32? Yes, 36. So, what is the opposite side of 36 degree angle? That is segment AD. So, therefore, segment AD is greater than segment CD. So, the symbol is greater than. Then, to solve the possible values of x, kopyahin lang natin yan. Segment AD is greater than segment CD. By substitution, papaltan lang natin si AD ng 2x. Is greater than, papaltan natin si CD ng x plus 3. So, tingnan natin yung kanan. Mayroon po ba kayong nakitang term na may variable? Yes. So, minus x, minus x. So, 2x minus x, x is greater than 3. So, the possible measures of x or values of x is greater than 3. So, mag-start tayo sa 4, 5, 6, up to positive infinity. Example number 3. Solve for the possible values of x. So, meron tayong given a included angle. 100 degrees and 30 degrees. So, which is larger? 100 degree or 30 degrees? Very good. 100 degree. So, ibig sabihin, pwede nating sabihin that segment FH is greater than segment EG. By substitution, papaltan natin si FH ng 5x plus 3 is greater than, papaltan natin sa segment AG ng 3x plus 9. So, tingnan uli natin yung kanan. Meron po bang term na may variable? Yes, so 3x yan. Kailangan mawala siya dyan sa kanan. So, minus 3x, minus 3x. Tingnan natin ang kaliwa. May constant po ba? Yes, meron. So, 3. So, ang gagawin natin, minus 3, minus 3. Then, after that, simplify. 5x minus 3x, that is 2x. So, 0 na to. 0 na rin to. So, 9 minus 3 is 6. Then, meron pong coefficient ng na 2, yung x natin. So, anong gagawin? We divide both sides by 2. Divide out lang natin. Then, x is greater than 3. So, the possible values of x is greater than 3. So, mag-start po tayo sa 4, 5, 6, up to positive infinity. Example number 4. Solve for the possible values of x. Now, since kung mapapansin nyo po, it is an equilateral triangle. So, kung equal po yan, lahat, ibig sabihin, equal din po yung angles. So, therefore, one of the angles or yung tinatawag nating included angle is 60 degree. So, ngayon po, tingnan natin yung angle. Alin ang mas malaki? 60 degrees o 45 degrees? 60 degrees. So, ano po yung opposite side natin? Sukat, x plus 5. So, therefore, x plus 5 is greater than 3x minus 7. So, tingnan yung kanan. Meron po tayong term na may variable. So, minus 3x, minus 3x. Sa kaliwa, meron tayong constant. So, minus 5, minus 5. Then, simplify. X minus 3x. So, lagi nyong tatandaan, basta po magkaiba ng sign, we're going to copy the sign of the larger number, then subtract. So, that is negative 2x. Then, negative 7 minus 5. So, magkapares po ang sign. What are we going to do? Copy the common sign, then add. Then, divide both sides by negative 2. Divide out lang natin. Then, x is greater than negative 12 divided by negative 2 is positive 6. So, the possible measures or values of x is or from 7, 8, 9 up to positive infinity. So, let's move on to converse of hinge theorem o yung tinatawag nating SSS, triangle inequality theorem. So, if two sides of one triangle are congruent to the two sides of another triangle, and the third side of the first is longer than the third side of the second, then the included angle of the first is larger than the included angle of the second. So, kung dito po, ang kino-compare lamang po sa converse of hinge theorem is the included angle. So, angle po ang kino-compare natin. Let us have this example. So, congruent po yung dalawang side. So, titingnan natin yung measure ng third side. So, 13 at 14. Ang i-compare natin is angle 1 at saka si angle 2. So, now, which is longer, 13 or 14? That is 14. Now, what is the opposite angle? That is measure of angle 2. Dahil mahaba po yan, longer side, ito po ang larger angle. So, that is less than. Next, 39 and 42. So, which is longer? So, that is 42. Ang opposite angle natin ay angle 1. So, therefore, ang angle 1 po, sukat ni angle 1 o measure of angle 1 is greater than measure of angle 2. So, example number 3. So, may measure 6 and 5. So, ano po yung opposite ni 6 na to? Yan po yun, anong angle? So, measure of angle A is greater than the measure of angle D. So, example number 1. Solve for the possible values of x. So, kung mapapansin nyo po, may congruent side po tayo at mayroon po tayong given third side. So, alin ang mas malaki ulit or mas mahaba? 6. So, segment BC. So, ibig sabihin, measure of angle A is greater than measure of angle D. Now, by substitution, papalitan lang natin si measure ng angle A ng 5x plus 3 is greater than si measure of angle D, papalitan natin ng 38. Then, ang gagawin po natin, wala pong term na may variable po dito sa kanan, so tingnan natin yung kaliwa. So, may constant ba? Yes. So, ang gagawin, minus 3 minus 3. Then, copy lang natin si 5x kasi 0 na to. Then, 38 minus 3 is greater than 35. Then, divide both side by 5. Then, divide out. Ang x natin is greater than 7. So, the possible values of x is 8, 9, 10 up to positive infinity. So, activity number 1, fill in the missing parts of the solution. So, ano po yung inequality symbol na nandito? Papalitan nyo lang po yung sukat ni FH. Papalitan nyo lang po yung sukat ni GE. Then, si-simplify nyo lang po ito. Dito po ilalagay ang sagot. Then, simplify nyo po ito. Ito ang sagot. Then, put the possible values of x. For number 2, fill in the blanks din po. Next, activity number 2, write and solve an inequality for possible values of x. Yun po yung number 1. Show a step-by-step solution. So, anong unang gagawin natin? Let's compare first the third side of the triangle. After nyan, atin pong isa-substitute. Papalitan lang natin po yung mga segments ng mga sukat. Then, we simplify. Makukuha natin yung value ng x. Then, kukunin natin po yung possible values of x. For number 2, ganun din. Write and solve an inequality for possible values of x. Show a step-by-step solution. Then, for number 3, solve for the values of, or the value of x. Measure of angle QRH. So, ito po yung exterior angle ang hinahanap, QRH. At yung sukat po ng angle Q. Ito po yun. So, this activity po, itong number 3 po ito, it involves exterior angle is equal to one remote interior angle plus the other remote interior angle. So, yun po yung formula na gagamitin natin para po makuha natin si x. Then, use by substitution para po makuha natin yung mismong sukat ng atin pong exterior angle. Then, substitute the value of x ulit. Papalitan lang natin yung x dito ng sagot. Then, simplify lang natin para makuha natin ang mismong sukat ni angle Q.